Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today we will be discussing a globally renowned topic, the colossal engineering projects in China that have amazed the world. You may have noticed that China is often referred to internationally as the infrastructure maniac. This is not meant to be derogatory, but rather a tribute to China's remarkable achievements in infrastructure development. As one of the world's largest developing countries, China has continuously promoted its economic and social development through infrastructure construction. Chinese engineers seem like superheroes in the field of construction, dedicated to creating grand projects that meet the needs of the nation's growing population. In this video, we will delve into the stories behind these massive Chinese engineering projects. Before we officially start the video, we sincerely invite you to subscribe and turn on notifications to ensure you don't miss any of our exciting content updates. We highly value your thoughts and look forward to hearing your opinions on these outstanding Chinese engineering achievements in the comments section. As an old Chinese saying goes, to get rich, build roads first. Indeed, transportation is the cornerstone of economic development and a crucial guarantee. Prosperity can only come when people and goods can move smoothly. Engineering and technology are forces that reshape the world, accelerating the wheels of history and fueling the progress of human civilization. Today, as China rises to become the world's second largest economy and the leading manufacturing powerhouse, it is also proving its extraordinary engineering capability, gaining global recognition as an infrastructure giant. A series of breathtaking mega projects has showcased China's national strength and vitality to the world. Amid global economic shifts and China's new stage of development, these projects, defined by their massive scale, technical complexity, enormous investment, and long-term impact, span transportation, construction, water management, energy, and even defense. In just a decade, China has built and put into operation 45,000 kilometers of high-speed rail lines. By comparison, Japan and Europe took nearly three times as long to develop their own high-speed networks, and their scale is only a fraction of China's. Today, China's high-speed rail network alone exceeds the total of all other countries combined. Technologically, it has moved from importing to leading, pioneering the high-speed rail 4.0 era. The Three Gorges Dam is the largest and most complex hydropower project on Earth. The south-to-north water diversion project is the most ambitious interbasin water transfer in human history. And the land reclamation in the Nansha Islands has been hailed as a miracle of nature's craftsmanship. And among these mega projects, one is pushing the very limits of human engineering, the world's largest island-to-land connection project. From the sky, you're about to witness one of the boldest engineering feats on Earth, the Zhuhai Bridge, the world's largest island-to-mainland connection. Its 1,650-meter main span leaps across the sea in a single breath, holding the crown as China's longest span bridge for 10 years straight. But this is just the beginning. Together with the Jintang, Taoyuan, Xiangjiaoyuan, and Chenggang bridges, a chain of mega bridges stretches nearly 50 kilometers, binding once isolated islands into one seamless whole. 9 years later, the 8-kilometer Yushan Bridge rose to link Yushan Island with Daishan Island. 12 years after that, the 25-kilometer Zhoshan-Daishan Bridge connected Daishan Island to Zhoshan's main island. Together with the 32.5-kilometer Donghai Bridge, which links Shanghai to Xiaoyangshan Island, and the Liuheng Highway Bridge now under construction, a series of expressways have stretched across the sea, building new land right above the waves. The result? China gained the world's busiest cargo port, the second-largest offshore green petrochemical base, and its very first major fishing ground. This is not just a bridge, it's a super connection that reshaped China's coastline and redefined what's possible in modern engineering. After conquering cross-sea bridges, China has set its sights on an even greater challenge, undersea tunnels. Here, you are about to see the world's longest undersea high-speed rail tunnel, the Jintang Undersea Tunnel, stretching 16.18 kilometers in total, with 11.21 kilometers of shield-driven section beneath the seabed. This tunnel is nothing short of a super engineering feat. Its cross-section measures a massive 14.5 meters in diameter, as tall as a five-story building, large enough to accommodate dual high-speed rail tracks. The construction relies on the colossal shield machine, Dingai, with a cutter head nearly 15 meters across. Its steel blades work like the fangs of a giant beast, slicing through layers of rock and soil. Guided with pinpoint accuracy by China's Beidou satellite navigation system, it advances toward another shield machine, Yongzhou, coming from the opposite direction. Deep under the seabed, the two machines will finally meet with millimeter-level precision. So why is the Jintang Undersea Tunnel hailed as the world's number one? The key lies in one word, high speed. Its design speed reaches 250 kilometers per hour, far exceeding the channel tunnel between Britain and France in Japan's Seikan Tunnel. By high-speed rail standards, Jintang's length and scale are unmatched anywhere on Earth. But the greatest challenges are not just about being long. The tunnel runs 78 meters below sea level, where shield machines must withstand enormous water pressure. Along the route, they face 28 geological transitions, alternating between solid rock and soft soil. To overcome this, engineers made special modifications, adding water injection pipes on the cutter head to handle sticky clay, reinforcing the sealing systems to resist extreme pressure, and upgrading the drive system for long-distance stability. Construction follows a dual shield approach. Yongzhou advanced 4,940 meters from the Ningbo side. Dingai dug 6,270 meters from the Joshan side. Why the difference? Because the geology is uneven. Rock on one side, softer soil on the other, making symmetrical digging impossible. The final meeting point was deliberately chosen within a stable rock formation, the only way to guarantee a safe and accurate junction. And accuracy is everything. In an undersea tunnel, even the tiniest error in manual surveying multiplies over distance. One wrong calculation, and you could end up with two separate tunnels instead of one. To prevent disaster, engineers deployed six Beidou satellites linked to the shield machine's auto-navigation systems, correcting deviations in real time. In the end, the alignment error was kept within just 2 centimeters. Then came the final challenge, how to remove the machines. When the two titans meet underground, there is no exit ahead and no way back. The solution? A technique called shedding the shell. The shield machines are dismantled piece by piece and hauled out, while their massive steel casings remain in the tunnel, permanently reinforcing its structure. According to plan, the Jintang Undersea Tunnel will be fully bored through by the end of 2026 and open to traffic with the Yongzhou Railway in 2028. Once complete, passengers will be able to travel from Ningbo to Zhoushan in just 30 minutes by high-speed train, ending the island's long history of having no rail connection. And while officials may not say it openly, many already see the bigger picture. This tunnel is not just a passage to Zhoushan, it may well be the testbed for the Taiwan Strait Tunnel. If China ever attempts to build across the strait, this will have been the most critical rehearsal. So, just how advanced is China's technology for building underwater tunnels? To answer that, let's take the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge Tunnel as an example. Here's the big question. The ocean is full of water. So how do you build a tunnel beneath the seabed? And how did Chinese engineers manage to construct a 6.7 kilometer underwater tunnel 40 meters below sea level? At first, engineers considered using tunnel boring machines. But since TBMS require extremely high stability, the tunnels they dug went much deeper than the design required. That meant they needed another solution. Their goal was to build a massive sea-crossing bridge that could connect Hong Kong, Zhuhai, and Macau, a project now hailed as one of the seven wonders of the modern world. The final solution was immersed tube tunnel technology. In this method, trenches are dredged on the seabed. Prefabricated concrete tunnel sections, called immersion tubes, are then lowered into these trenches, aligned underwater, joined together, and finally backfilled with sand and gravel. Each tunnel section is 180 meters long, weighing 76,000 tons, about the same as an aircraft carrier. Each one contains 2 3-lane carriageways and 2 service tunnels. Chinese engineers had to lower and align these massive tubes one by one, but manufacturing a single 180 meter, 76,000 ton reinforced concrete unit in one piece was practically impossible. The solution? Engineers divided each tunnel section into 8 smaller parts. Prefabricated them in a factory, and then joined them into a single 180 meter unit. In total, the project consumed 330,000 tons of steel and 2 million tons of concrete, enough to build 8 Burj Khalifa towers. On the uninhabited Niutu Island, over 3,000 workers built a massive factory in just 100 days. Its only task to produce the 33 immersion tubes required at a rate of 2 per month, each weighing 76,000 tons. After more than 1,400 days of construction, nearly all tunnel sections were in place. The final piece, E30, was carefully lowered into position. Slowly, steel cables lowered the giant section to the seabed, while engineers above monitored every detail in real time. After 26 hours of precise adjustment, E-30 was finally seated in place. Divers then entered the seabed, carrying out millimeter-level measurements to ensure the alignment was perfect. Once confirmed, the last segment was sealed, and the world-shocking Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge underwater tunnel was complete. This is not just about a tunnel. It's about speed, precision, and national ambition. A netizen compared China's rise to human learning. You get smarter from both success and failure. China is like a sponge, absorbing and improving technology. Many of these mega projects are not done for show, but to make things better. As one user put it bluntly, the US spends over $1.5 trillion on defense instead of modern infrastructure. Imagine what both countries could achieve if they worked together on infrastructure. One foreign commenter said, "These mega projects showcase China's engineering prowess and ambition, reshaping the country's landscape and connecting its vast population." But these projects come at a hefty price, often hidden from public view. The construction of these mega projects often involves massive land acquisition, deforestation, and the displacement of local communities. The environmental impact of these projects is significant, contributing to air and water pollution, habitat destruction, and climate change. Recent examples include the Three Gorges Dam, which displaced millions and altered the natural flow of the Yangtze River, and the Belt and Road Initiative, which has raised concerns about environmental sustainability in participating countries. While these projects promise economic growth, they often come at the expense of social equity and human rights. The construction of these projects has led to forced evictions, the suppression of dissent, and the exploitation of laborers. The lack of transparency and accountability surrounding these projects raises concerns about their social and ethical implications. Others see it in even grander terms. China is the first since ancient times, just sleepy for a while. Now it's returning to its rightful place. No one can stop it. Construction flows in the bloodstream of Chinese people. They have been building for thousands of years, and they're still building. The sky is the limit for China's achievements. From cross-sea bridges to underwater tunnels, from high-speed rail networks to megawater projects, China keeps redefining the limits of human engineering. These are not just structures of steel and concrete. They are symbols of ambition, vision, and determination. Of course, such projects spark debate worldwide. Some marvel at China's speed and precision, while others question the social and environmental costs. But one thing is undeniable. China has shown the world that the future is not something you wait for, it's something you build. So what do you think? Are China's mega projects a new chapter in human civilization or a massive gamble? Share your thoughts in the comments below. China has repeatedly pushed the limits of human engineering. These projects are not only transforming China, but reshaping the world. But this is just the beginning. In our next episode, we'll take you inside an even more audacious and strategic project, the Pinglu Canal. How will this canal of the century redefine the economy of Southwest China? And why did foreign viewers compare it to an alien base straight out of a science fiction movie? Don't miss it. Hit that subscribe button and join us as we uncover the answer.